يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون فإذا قضيت الصلاة فانتشروا في الأرض وابتغوا من فضل الله واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون وإذا رأوا تجارة أو لهوا انفضوا إليها وتركوك قائما قل ما عند الله خير من اللهو ومن التجارة والله خير الرازقين
الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم حمدا لا يتناهى الحمد لله فاطر السماوات والأرض جاعل الملائكة رسلا أولي أجنحة مثنى وثلاث ورباع يزيد في الخلق ما يشاء إن الله على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين وصل على محمد في الآخرين وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين يقول الحق تبارك وتعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون الله عز وجل saying to us I'm talking to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم in the Quran Kareem saying Oh Muhammad if they ask you about me means about Allah عز وجل say to them I'm near to them answering the call of the one who ask answering the call of the one who do dua then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say if they do dua If they do it, then Allah answer. If you do not do, Allah will not answer you in anything. If you do dua, then Allah Azza wa Jal answer it. إِذَا دَعَانْ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ Let them answer me and let them follow me in order for them to be rightly guided. And I stop the last time with the اسم الله الأعظم and I explain from the Quran completely the great name of Allah, the greatest name of Allah. And what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about the ayat, some certain ayat and some certain surah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the great name of Allah in it. Then I moved to the sunnah of the dua, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said Ismullah al-A'zam in it. Then I moved after that to Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani for the different of the saying of the ulama and he collected 14 different opinions about the great name of Allah. Let us now learn some of the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let's hope about some of the dua and the meaning of it and going on more. And all of this, if you remember, this dua is a part still with the khutbah of the reason of rizq. But because of the important in it, important of it, I give more details to this one. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said to one of the people لو كان عليك مثل جبل مثل أحد دينا أداه الله عنك رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم told us one of the dua and he said to us that if you have a debt alone upon you equal to Uhud mountain, very huge, then you repeat this dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say it on behalf of you. Allah will make it easy for you to pay. What it is? اللهم اكفني بحلالك عن حرامك وبطاعتك عن معصيتك واغنني بفضلك عمن سواك. So easy, I need you only just to repeat it as much as you can. The meaning, اللهم اكفني بحلالك عن حرامك. Oh Allah, say, Oh Allah, make me rich and make me be satisfied with the halal and the haram. وبطاعتك عن معصيتك, make me busy with obeying you, not disobeying you. واغنني بفضلك عمن سواك, and make me rich with your superiority rather than anyone else. Make me because of your blessing, not because of anybody else. Also, Abu Umamah was in the masjid one time and was complaining about some debt upon him and some distress he had. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم told him also to say in the morning and the evening, اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الهم والحزن وأعوذ بك من العجز والكسل وأعوذ بك من البخل والجبن وأعوذ بك من غلبة الدين وقهر الرجال. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الهم والحزن. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from the الهم, different than الحزن. الهم, it is a distress coming to you because of the worried about the future. The distress and feeling sad and bad and sorrow and worried about the future. This is the name الهم. الحزن, when you feel bad and sad about whatever already happened in the past. Bad things happened in the past, it will make you feel الحزن. Worried about the future, this is the name الهم. Allah and Rasulullah want to save you from being worried about the future or being feeling sad about the past, saying, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-hammi wal-hazan, from whatever coming in the future, and you will be worried about it, and save me from feeling sad about whatever already happened in the, whatever you lost of the money or wealth or health in the past. Wa'a'udhu bika min al-ajzi wal-kasal. Oh Allah, I seek refuge from you, with you from being disabled. Al-ajz also different than al-kasal. Al-ajz when you are not able to do because some of the your part outside or inside the organ is not working. Or you missed some of it. One of the hand is cut, one of the legs is cut. This is its name in Islam or in this dua. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من العجز والكسل. العجز when you are not able to do, disabled. الكسل when you are healthy but you are feeling lazy, you don't want to do. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ask Allah, oh Allah, save me from being disabled and from being lazy, from both of them. وأعوذ بك من العجز والكسل وأعوذ بك من البخل والجبن. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from being miserly and from being coward. وَأَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ غَلَبَةِ الدَّيْنِ وَقَهْرِ الرِّجَالِ. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from being under debt and from being under the pressure of other people. Look, subhanAllah, so small and so few words, and how long is the meaning of it. And also the meaning I'm saying in translation is not complete and perfect. This is some of the meaning. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran al-Kareem, Surah Al-Furqan, Surah number 25, Ayah number 77,
قُلْ مَا يَعْبَأُ بِكُمْ رَبِّي لَوْلَا دُعَاءُكُمْ.
Allah pay attention to you only because of your dua. In this ayah very clear, Allah pay attention to you only because of your dua. For that, do as much as you can. In al-Bukhari, hadith number 758, Allah Azza wa Jal come down to the nearest sky to us every night. In another hadith, every last third part of the night, after the middle of the night, after 12 o'clock till al-Fajr, saying, مَنْ يَدْعُونِي فَأَسْتَجِيبُ لَهُ. Allah himself come down and he say, Who do dua? I will answer him. من يسألني فأعطيه. Who ask me anything, I'll give it to him. من يستغفرني فأغفره. Who want forgiveness, I will forgive him. وذلك كل ليلة. And this is every night. Allah Azza wa Jalla come down and ask, who do dua? Who want anything? Who ask me? Who need forgiveness? And this is every night. Means from you, your side, ask Allah whatever you are able and learn this dua, the comprehensive dua of Rasulullah. The very easy one, majority of the Muslims memorize it from the Quran. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. Oh Allah, give us every good in the dunya and give us every good in the akhirah and save us from the torment of the hellfire. In Muslim, hadith number 1928, wal Bukhari, volume number 7, hadith number 154, wa silsila sahiha 2241. Another beautiful dua. And usually the people running behind these things, and it isn't the dua itself, just repeat it. Allah will make it too easy to you to have. Allahumma akthir mali wa waladi. Oh Allah, give me a lot of kids and a lot of money. Wabarik li fima a'taytani. Oh Allah, give me barakah in whatever you give me. Barakah means blessings. وَأَطِلْ حَيَاتِي عَلَىٰ طَاعَتِكَ. Oh Allah, give me a long life with your ta'ah, with obedience of Allah. Because long life with disobedience is so bad for you. But long life with obedience of Allah, this is the best for you. You will be in higher bliss in Jannah. وَأَطِلْ حَيَاتِي عَلَىٰ طَاعَتِكَ. وَأَحْسِنْ عَمَلِي. And make me do the best of the good deeds. The best of the good deeds. واغفر لي. And oh Allah, forgive me. Look how beautiful this one. And it is Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم teaching us. اللهم أكثر مالي وولدي وبارك لي فيما أعطيتني وأطل حياتي على طاعتك وأحسن عملي واغفر لي. Look to another one. In الحاكم volume number 1542 صحيح الجامع والسلسلة الصحيحة 1539. اللهم اجعل أوسع رزقك علي عند كبر سني وانقطاع عمري. Oh Allah, make the most and the much of your rizq upon me, the widest and the a lot of rizq for me, when I am old and near to the end of my life. Do you get it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us also, do you know when you get so old and near to the end of your life in the dunya, when you be near to die, a lot of people, they will not have a source of root, a lot of rizq. Sometimes there is no at all. Because the reason he used to have while he is young, while he is healthy, while he is strong, no more. For that Rasulullah teaching us, oh Allah, اجعل أوسع رزقك علي, make the much or the widest of the rizq for me, at the time of being old and at the time of near to the end of my life. اللهم اجعل أوسع رزقك علي عند كبر سني وانقطاع عمري. Look to صحيح الجامع حديث volume number 1 حديث number 399 وأحمد وغيره. اللهم اغفر لي ذنبي ووسع لي في داري وبارك لي في رزقي. Oh Allah, forgive my sin and give me wide and big house and give me barakah in my rizq. If you look also, because this part especially related to the part about the rizq, for that every dua have some part about the rizq itself, and this is the reason I bring it alone. In النسائي وابو داود وصحيح الجامع حديث number 407. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الفقر والقلة والذلة وأعوذ بك من أن أظلم أو أظلم أو أعتدي أو يعتدى علي. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from being poor. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from being submissive by other people. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from being ظالم or مظلوم. Means, oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from doing wrong against others or from being under the wrong from others. When you do wrong against others, it's in dhulm. مظلوم when the other do wrong against you. Oh Allah, save me from doing against the other and save me from the wrong of the other people. Oh Allah, save me from being transgress the limit against the other and save me from other people who is evil and they can transgress the limit against me. Look how beautiful the dua, you should learn it. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الفقر والقلة والذلة وأعوذ بك من أن أظلم أو أظلم أو أعتدي أو يعتدى علي. And this hadith have more narrations also. In صحيح النسائي volume number 1 hadith number 280. اللهم إني أسألك القصد في الفقر والغنى وأسألك نعيما لا ينفث وأسألك قرة عين لا تنقطع وأسألك الرضا الرضا بعد القضاء وأسألك برد العيش بعد الموت. So beautiful hadith and so beautiful dua, every Muslim should learn it. Yes, maybe you will not get all of this at this time, but alhamdulillah for yourself, if you have intention to learn, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it to you. اللهم إني أسألك القصد في الغنى والفقر. Oh Allah, make me moderate while I am rich, while I am poor. Because sometimes you will be moderate while you are poor. But when Allah gives you a lot of money, you will transgress and spend everywhere, a lot of money everywhere. For that, oh Allah, make me moderate for being poor or being rich. وَأَسْأَلُكَ نَعِيمًا لَا يَنْفَدْ. Oh Allah, whatever you give me from your favor, oh Allah, do not make it non-stop. Make it continuously. Because sometimes you will have a lot of goodness for a while. Then after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of a test to you, and out of some of what you did, Allah will stop it. This dua, oh Allah, make it continuously coming to me by your blessings. وَأَسْأَلُكَ قُرَّةَ عَيْنٍ لَا تَنْقَطِعُ. Oh Allah, bless my kids. This is the nearest meaning to it. And have a lot of meaning also. Oh Allah, make me continuously in my salah. This is one of the meaning. وَأَسْأَلُكَ الرِّضَى بَعْدَ الْقَضَى. Oh Allah, I am asking you to be always happy with whatever decision you decide me. And all of your life is a decision of Allah. Oh Allah, make me happy with whatever you decide to me. وَأَسْأَلُكَ بَرْدَ الْعَيْشِ بَعْدَ الْمَوْتِ. Oh Allah, give me a good life after I die. Oh Allah, give me a good life after I die. Because you don't know what will happen to you in your grave. You don't know what will happen to you in the hereafter. Either for two ways, al-Jannah or al-Nar, or of your good deeds and bad deeds equal, and you have still some right to other people, you will be in al-A'raf. A place between al-Jannah and al-Nar. You will not be with those or this until those people get the right from you. Then after that, if your good deeds be higher than the bad, you will be admitted to al-Jannah. If your bad deeds, wal-a'azu billah, say, we ask Allah to save us, say Ameen. If your bad deeds is higher, you will be admitted to al-Nar, to Jahannam. Also, in the terms of hadith number 523, volume number 5, Allahumma rzuqni hubbuk. Oh Allah, give me, here the rizq, do you remember when I told you one time, the rizq is too many different kinds. One of it is the money, or the kids, or the health, or the certificate, or the good deeds, or also the work you have, the job. The knowledge is part of your rizq, the food, the land, the houses. Iman and love of Allah part of this. Hikmah also I told you about. The wisdom, the clothes, even the rain, part of your rizq, under the rizq. The power, the position, the animals. Any provision or sustenance or any good having to use part under your rizq. Here, one of the rizq, Allahumma rzuqni hubbuka. Oh Allah, give me one of the rizq. This is to your heart. Love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the best of it. Not only that, listen to the next. وَحُبُّ مَنْ يَنْفَعُنِي حُبُّهُ عِنْدَكَ. And oh Allah, not only love of you, love of the one, his love, my love to him will benefit me with you. Like who? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Good. Because when you love Rasulullah, this is will benefit you with Allah. For that Allahumma rzuqni hubbuka wa hubbu man yanfa'uni hubbuhu indak. Allahumma ma rzaqtani mimma uhib faj'alhu quwwatan li fi ma tuhib. Oh Allah, whatever anything good I love it and you give it to me, make it for me a power for whatever you love. Means use it for your love. Means Allah give you whatever you love of the money, whatever you love of the health or wealth. Oh Allah, make me use that for your love. Use that for your sake. اللهم ما زويت عني مما أحب فاجعله فراغا لي فيما تحب. Oh Allah, whatever you make anything I love and you make it to avoid me, oh Allah, you did not give it to me, make this also a time for me to give me a time for more love to you and for more love for whatever you love. Look how beautiful is this hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Enough, اللهم ارزقني حبك. Oh Allah, give me the love of you. Because if you get it, whole worldly life and whatever in it will never be with you nothing. But if you love the dunya more than the love of Allah, this is calamity you have, sometime you will not feel it. But ask yourself how much of time you give to Allah and how much of time you give to the deen of Allah or to the worship of Allah or to the love of Allah. I think you will know the answer. Also, عن ابن عباس والحاكم والذهبي, and it is in الذهبي 510. اللهم قنعني بما رزقتني وبارك لي فيه واخلف علي كل غائبة لي بخير واجعل كل قضاء قضيته لنا خيرا. This khutbah still was learning some of the dua related to the rizq also and related to general dua of a different things like this one. اللهم قنعني بما رزقتني. Oh Allah, make me satisfied with whatever rizq you give me. Because Rasulullah already told us, he said, some people, they will get a day, 100 dinar, and still they are not happy. This is what's happening these days. Some of us, they get sometimes more than this, still they are not happy. Rasulullah say, ask Allah, oh Allah, make me satisfied, make me happy, make me pleased with whatever you give me. Because whatever you have is not because you are smart. No. It's not because you work hard. No, Allah. Some people more smarter than you, and you don't get what you have. Some people more workers than you, they don't give half of what you have. It is from Allah Azza wa Jalla. And here's the dua. Oh Allah, make me happy and make me pleased and make me satisfied with whatever you provide me, with whatever you give it to me. And when you have that, and being shakir, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. Allah will give you more. Being thankful to Allah and grateful, when you do not deny the favor of Allah and go back to the khutbah about being thankful and being grateful to Allah. It was so long, 2 or 3. About how you be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here, وَبَارِكْ لِي فِيهِ. Not only make me happy and pleased with whatever you give me, oh Allah, give me barakah in it. Some people, they have billions and millions. And at the same time, there is no any barakah. Right or wrong? Some of us, they have the salary so and so, big amount. At the same time, no barakah in it. A lot of gates to swallow this in the beginning of the month, and after that you have nothing. Some others you don't have, and Allah gives them barakah. Some of the people, very, very rich, and income so much, and his son gets sick, he ran to a billion doctor. At the same time, some other one, Allah give him barakah, and his son becomes the same sickness of this one. Just he is read Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim al-Fatiha and some other dua and some water, Zamzam water or whatever, give it to him, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Look to the barakah. This is his been millions and this is his been nothing. This is because no barakah and this is because of barakah and too many other listen in the same situation, but this is part of it. Also, وَخْلُفْ عَلَيَّ كُلَّ غَائِبَةٍ لِي بِخَيْرٍ. Oh Allah, give me the goodness of whatever I didn't get. Because sometimes you like to get something and you didn't get it. Be thankful to Allah. And oh Allah, give me better than it. Oh Allah, give me, as the hadith say, وَخْلُفْ عَلَيَّ كُلَّ غَائِبَةٍ لِي بِخَيْرٍ. Whatever I didn't get, give me goodness and give me better and give me reward of whatever I did not get. وَاجْعَلْ كُلَّ قَضَاءٍ قَضَيْتَهُ لِي خَيْرًا. Oh Allah, make every decision to me the best. Best of the decision, and best of whatever you will lie, and the best of whatever will save you from the worldly life, and admit you to Jannah, and save you from Allah. In Tirmizi also, hadith number 3173, والحاكم وأذرس. اللهم زدنا ولا تنقصنا. اللهم اكرمنا ولا تهنا. اللهم اعطنا ولا تحرمنا. اللهم آثرنا ولا تؤثر علينا، اللهم ارضنا وارض عنا. سي آمين. اللهم زدنا ولا تنقصنا. Oh Allah, give us more and do not decrease what we have. Oh Allah, give us more and do not decrease what we have. More of goodness. وَكْرِمْنَا وَلَا تُهِنَّا. Oh Allah, increase our dignity. Increase our own superiority by you. And oh Allah, do not disgrace us. Do not put us down. Because مَنْ يُهِنِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ مُكْرِمٍ. Whoever Allah raises him, nobody can put him down. And whoever Allah put him down, nobody can raise him up. وَعْطِنَا وَلَا تَحْرِمْنَا. Oh Allah, give us all with them continuously and do not prevent us from every good. وَآثِرْنَا وَلَا تُؤْثِرْ عَلَيْنَا. Oh Allah, give us all with more than others. Oh Allah, give us all with more than others and bless whatever you give it to us. وَارْضِنَا وَارْضَ عَنَّا. Oh Allah, make us happy and oh Allah, be happy on us. Be pleased with us. Be pleased with us. Look how beautiful is this dua. Every Muslim should learn it. اللهم زدنا ولا تنقصنا وكرمنا ولا تهنا واعطنا ولا تحرمنا وآثرنا ولا تؤثر علينا وارضنا وارض عنا يا رب العالمين. آمين. أقول قولي هذا وأدعو الله وأنتم موقنون. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. In the سلسلة الصحيحة حديث number 2866 رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said إن نفسا لن تموت حتى تستكمل رزقها وأجلها فاتقوا الله وأجملوا في الطلب ولا يحملنكم استبطاء رزق على معصية الله فإنه لا ينال ما عند الله إلا بطاعته. رسول الله telling you something about the عقيدة. Your عقيدة and your رزق. I did already the part of the dua about the رزق. Then going on with the عقيدة about the رزق. That Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, nobody will die until he will have completely his rizq and his ajal also, his lifetime. You will never be decreased of anything of it. Allah, Rasulullah say, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Have more taqwa. Fear Allah only. Don't fear about your rizq at all. وَأَجْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ. And also when you seek, there is another hadith of Rasulullah about this point. وَاطْلُبُوا الْحَوَائِجَ بِعِزَّةِ الْأَنفُسِ. فإن الأمور تجري بالمقادير. When you seek the help of other people or when you ask somebody else something, ask with عزت. Do not submissive yourself to anybody. Because everything running by مقدار. Everything running by the decision of Allah. If Allah write it to you with only just humble and simple asking, I'm not saying being arrogant. There is difference between both. Do not be arrogant because forbidden to be arrogant in Islam. But also do not be so submissive to him to ask about anything, because everything going by the qadar of Allah. If Allah write it to you, it will come. If Allah does not write it to you, it doesn't matter what you do. It will never come to you. For that the aqidah of the Muslim, ما قدر لك لن يأخذه غيرك. Whatever already decided to you, nobody at all will have it except you. Because decided by who? By Allah Azza wa Jal, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you remember at the beginning of the rizq, I told you hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that if you're running away from your rizq, not towards the rizq, if this is the rizq and you're running away from it, you don't want it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, exactly example to understand it more, as if you're running away from your death. Did you see when you have the death, going to have accident while you are, what will you do? You will go for it, will you try to run away from it? You'll try to run away from it. This is what Rasulullah say, if you're running away from your rizq, from your provision, whatever written to you, as you're running away from your death, when you see that it is coming toward you, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, your rizq will catch you, as also your death will catch you. Is there any doubt about that the death will catch you? You cannot run away from it. Did you ever see anyone run away from the death? From mouth? Impossible. The same with the rizq. At the same time, I am not saying neglect and go sleep and say already rizq. No, work. Because Allah ordered you to take the reasons. Take the reason and the halal reason to get it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy to reach to you. And it will run behind you to get it. And I think if you think about your lifetime, you will find a lot of things you yourself does not do too much for it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give it to you. Just because of the simple reason already you did, and already Allah write it down to you. For that if you're running away, this is for your aqidah to be satisfied, and to be happy, and to be pleased. Only just ask Allah, this khutab, all of it about the rizq. And there is two kinds of reasons. Worldly life reason, everybody knows it. The certificate and the job and the this and that, too many. And there is shar'i reason, this is what I'm explaining. And especially the dua. Always ask Allah, because in His hand, khazainu samawati wal ard, treasures of the heaven and the earth. For that here in this hadith, saying that, وَلَا يَحْمِلَنَّكُمْ اسْتِبْطَاءُ رِزْقٍ عَلَى مَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهُ لَا يُنَالُ مَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا بِطَاعَتِهِ. Never ever, if your rizq becomes slow to come to you, never disobey Allah. Do not think that by disobeying Allah you will get more rizq. No, you will get more sin. Because whatever with Allah, you will get it with obeying Allah, not with disobeying Allah. Not with disobeying. Already written something to you. Two ways to the same thing. One halal way and one haram way. Choose for yourself and you will be accountable. And whatever written, written. But by your choice, and you will be accountable about what you choose. Did you choose to go to it with the halal and right? Or to go to it and get it with the haram and wrong? اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اللهم كفر عنا سيئاتنا. اللهم توفنا مع الأبرار. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم انصرنا ولا تنصر علينا. وأعنا ولا تعن علينا. وانصرنا على من بغى علينا. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. فوق كل أرض وتحت كل سماء يا رب العالمين. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها. وزكها أنت خير من زكاها. أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم زدنا ولا تنقصنا، وكرمنا ولا تهنا، واعطنا ولا تحرمنا، وآثرنا ولا تؤثر علينا. اللهم آثرنا ولا تؤثر علينا، واغننا بحلالك عن حرامك، وبطاعتك عن معصيتك، وبفضلك عمن سواك يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا وأهالينا وبلاد المسلمين في ضمانك وأمانك وإحسانك وحفظك ورعايتك ونصرك وتأييدك يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر من نصرنا، واخذل من خذلنا، واجعلنا متبعين لا مبتدعين يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل، ونعوذ بك اللهم من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. وصل اللهم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، وجزاكم الله خيرا.